I think Robert's been a wonderful addition, and you know, it's just it's cool when you've got a character that you've established and you feel like you know, so it's easy to kind of find the truth within that, but then to have someone else kind of helping nudge you in a certain direction and just taking on those other ideas. And you know, for me it was cool because he was interested in a side of Eric that I hadn't been able to sort of play in Divergent, which keeps it interesting for me. You know, and we're also like, you know, the scope of this film is much broader, and it kind of it sprawls a lot more. And so it was kind of, yeah, it's like whilst we had the roots of something that we created in the first one, it was like doing a whole different film as well. And I think having someone else helming it really adds to that. It is a bit more of a fun ride. And I think just because it takes us out of that one world, you know, and we get to, you know, dip into the other factions and, you know, it's more of a visual experience. You know, meeting new characters. It's great when you have like a core group that you can follow, these protagonists, but I think it's fun for the audience to get to know a bit more about the other people that exist in this society as well. It appeals to kind of almost anybody, and it has that kind of mass appeal quality to it, these stories. And I think that's the surprising thing, is that people who perhaps aren't or don't think they're in the target demographic for a movie like this really enjoy it. And I, you know, you hear that a lot. Guys my age will see Divergent and you know, talk about how they were surprised they really loved it. I think we're lucky to have the fan base we do, because you know, you can't kind of keep these things alive without them. And it's kind of an incredible thing. I mean, nothing else I've worked on carries that sort of sense of support and like just utter passion for it. Like, people just get behind this stuff and they, you know, they want to know these characters. And especially nowadays with social media, it's somewhat fascinating. And I'm not that dialed into that world, but yeah, it's certainly, you know, as far as anything I've been involved with, this is the thing that catches, you know, the most attention.
Hey, all you Dark Knight fans, Valerie here. Now, I have an interesting fact from the film. Did you know that for the first 4 days of productions, Christopher Nolan put cast and crew under a movie bootcamp comprising 8 films whose turn he wanted to emulate? In chronological order, these were King Kong, Citizen Kane, Cat People, Stalag 17, Black Sunday, A Clockwork Orange, Heat, and Batman Begins. What an interesting mix. Download our Film Is Now app, available for both Android and iOS.